summertime, apples in the fall. If I can't have the girl I love, I don't want none at all. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove I know. Shady Grove, my little love, I'm bound for Shady Grove. Tune I play on it, I wish that girl was mine. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove I know. Shady Grove, my little love, I'm bound for Shady Grove. Pretty gal to my side and down the road I'd go. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove I know. Shady Grove, my little love, I'm bound for Shady Grove.
We're going to separate a few things. So we've got our chicken over here. We're going to have to pull that apart. We've got all our stock vegetables over here.
We're just going to get rid of all the big chunks. And the only thing you should have to pull out is if you have any stems from any herbs that you use. Now, if you don't have one of these mixers, you can always put all of this in a blender and blend it down. You're going to take off all the skin. It's going to come off easy. And what you're going to be left with is the beautiful chicken meat. And then you'll pull all that meat off and put it in with your stock. Just about finished pulling all this chicken off. And I've accumulated a few friends along the way. While you should never, ever give a dog any chicken bones, the occasional free chicken meat is appreciated. Into the flour, and you're going to end up with a pretty consistent, but not doughy yet because you haven't added any moisture to it, but a nice consistent flour that's got that butter running all the way through it. From there, we're going to add in one egg. Gotta have some salt. I'm going to say we're about a teaspoon on the salt. Maybe half a teaspoon if you're watching your salt. And 1/4 cup of cold milk. Look at this, here you go. This isn't forming a dough, it's crumbly. That's actually what you want, is to see it crumbly. You see how some of the parts are sticking together, but not all of them? However, if you can pick it up and you can start molding it together, you're getting there. If you have to add a pinch more milk, add a pinch more milk, but do it a little bit at a time because you can really overdo it. It's going to be really crumbly and you're going to wonder about it, but just keep pressing it. You can use any kind of rolling pin that you want.
And just slowly start flattening it out. It took a little muscle, So that's how you keep your arms in shape, though, right there. And here's what you're left with, okay? Nothing pretty, nothing in a particular shape, but we. Now I'm going to add a little extra stock because I want to make a little extra. So I bought a stock to go with that really rich one that we just made.
And we're going to bring this up to just kind of a slow boil. And once it just starts bubbling a little bit, we'll add in our dumplings.
We're just going to scoop them up. Final step right here. I've got a little shy of maybe a quarter cup of cornstarch, and I'm going to add some milk. I'm not adding any kind of big cream or anything. I'm going over. That's 1% milk. You won't miss it. This will be nice and creamy. We got a rich stock.
But you do want to make sure
that you blend it in cold milk before you ever add it to the hot water.
Sundown in the Paris of the prairie, we kings of all treasures buried, and all you hear are the rusty reeds.
To do is take a picture of Angus. It's
Thanks, Angus.